Need screening is the process of taking this broad list of very diverse needs and really figuring out which ones are worth the time and energy to continue focusing. It's really a prioritization process.
Stage two of the biodesign process is a little bit about peeling the onion. So you want to kind of go layer by layer. You want to go deep enough so that you can really refine the need statements and have a very clear idea about what your goals and your outcomes are going to be.
Once you come out with those need statements and you feel like they're well written, your first question is, well, was just this a one-off or is this actually a problem?
We have to talk to the doctors and see, well, is that a real problem? Do they really care about it? And then we have to do our secondary research.
We looked at the current treatment landscape. We looked at medical procedures that people did. We looked at current technology that also addresses the same needs.
We really tried to understand the stakeholders, for example, and whether all the stakeholders were aligned in trying to improve the situation for patients.
Stakeholders that we spoke with included physicians, nurses, hospitalists, surgeons, basically anyone who was involved in that specific need.
We looked at market sizes. Was there a viable business we can build around this opportunity?
Spend the time doing the diligence to look at where the opportunities are, because then you know that the time you spend on an invention is worthwhile because it has a market that's going to support it.
So you don't go from 100 odd needs to top four in one go. You do it step by step. So the first filter we obviously applied was a subjective one. What needs do we want to work on as a team? What fits our team charter?
Value was very early. If it was not going to create value for the healthcare system, it did not make it to our final list of needs to brainstorm.
Well, the filters our team used for need screening progressed as we went along and knew more and more about the needs. And so initially we had a smaller set of filters, and then as we continued to narrow down our list and knew more and more, we added more complexity to our need filtering algorithm.
We use formulas, we use weightings, and we use scales.
I think the most important filters in our needs finding were understanding the patient population and the impact.
I think one of the big challenges as we went through the process was figuring out a truly objective way to screen the needs.
You tend to get attached to the needs that you have, so it's really hard to let go any of those.
We had jokes about having zombie needs that were cut but weren't really cut and could come back to life.
The uniqueness of stage two is that where projects and where needs compete against each other.
Many of the needs that initially we thought we liked a lot got kicked out. We just have to trust in our process.
One of the things we really tried to do is stick to the process, right? Let the process guide us and not get off track with, you know, personal biases.
If you really buy into the process and you follow the process it is, you're gonna have some rich results at the end of two or three projects that have survived through this process, that have actually been screened well, selected well, and have a best chance at going forward.